Sorry, I cannot speak Spanish. And I think this is also a problem for our conference, the languages. We have agreed that we mainly still speak in English, but that's for some of you a problem. We have one solution, Mrs. Volkmann. Where is she there? She is Chilean and she can translate, perhaps summarize things. If this will help, she can also help with Spanish and so on. And I hope we will find a good solution to come together with us. I welcome all of you to the RISM conference, Documenting Musical Sources in Latin America. I'm happy to welcome our dear guest from abroad, who traveled a long way from Argentina, Bolivia, Brazil, Chile, Colombia, Cuba, and Mexico. It is a great pleasure to have you here, and I thank you very much for coming. Two sponsors made the conference possible: the Deutsche Akademische Austauschdienst, German Academic Exchange Service, supported by the German Foreign Ministry, and Bibliothek Information International, a part of the German Goethe-Institut. We are happy and grateful to the Academy of Science, to the Akademie der Wissenschaften und der Literatur here in Mainz, for providing us with these wonderful rooms in a real quiet atmosphere. This is the right place for thinking and exchanging thoughts. Germany has eight academies of science that build together a union of academies of science. The union is the main financer of RISM, with the German working group based in Munich and Dresden, and the RISM Zentralredaktion in Frankfurt. That's we. The union is at the same time the main financer of 40 musikwissenschaftliche Editionen, Projects for musicological editions, most of them Gesamtaufgaben, complete editions. After the conclusion of the Neue Bach-Ausgabe and the Neue Mozart-Ausgabe, there are, for example, editions of the works of Johannes Brahms, Christoph Willibald Gluck, Georg Friedrich Hensel, Joseph Haydn, Max Reger, Arnold Schönberg, Franz Schubert, Robert Schumann, Karl Maria von Weber, and as one of the newest projects, Bernd Alois Zimmermann. All of these projects are coordinating here in Mainz from the same academy whose guest we have the privilege of being today. And I can welcome Mrs. Gabriele Buschmeier, who is the coordinator of all these projects from the Academy. From a musicological point of view, I always found it to be logical that RISM is finest within this framework, because knowledge of sources is a basic for producing catalogues of works and editions. On the other hand, musical sources are kept mainly in libraries and archives. They have their own interest, which is sometimes self-contradictory, protecting the sources, showing their important holdings to best represent the library, having good catalog records made according to international standards, building up digital resources, and so on, and giving and controlling access to scholars or people with special interest. Our guests are representatives of libraries, universities, and/or documentation project. We will introduce them before their presentations. RISM is situated exactly in between these parties. And this is also represented in this conference from the European side. You have just heard an introduction by Professor Pietschmann, who is the director of the musicological division of the university in Mainz. Also sitting with us is Professor Christina Uchuria, who is at the university in Bern. In Bern. Both are highly interested in research on process of exchange, race and institutions from Europe to Latin America and back. But how can they do it without the knowledge of sources? Before I show you some slides to introduce RISM, I would like to thank John Lazos for his translation of the brochure RISM and Overview into Spanish, RISM Presentación General. Thank you, John. You can take as many as you want and share them with your colleagues and students at home. A Portuguese version will follow next year. So now I must change this. So, charge of the organization. RISM aims to comprehensive documentation of extant musical sources worldwide. Charge of the organizations. These documented primary sources are manuscripts, like it is an example by Bach, printed music, and writings of music theory and libretti. They are housed in libraries, archives, monasteries, schools, private collections, and we normally say just libraries, but if we say libraries, then we mean all these organizations who own musical sources. A global organization with solid goals. About 40 countries around the world with one or more national RISM working groups take part in the project. In total, about 100 contributors describe the sources, the musical sources housed in their countries. They transmit the result to the RISM Central Editorial Office in Frankfurt, which then edits and publishes it. Our main projects are music manuscripts and prints, the so-called Series E. Series E is because it's in alphabet. It was planned to publish it in alphabetical order. Description of the repertories by thematic aspects, the Series B, and the Series C for RISM Library C class. Also RISM Library C class and informations about libraries and so on. And not so good coordinated is now the initiatives concerning libretti. Main project is since the 80s, music manuscripts after 1600, what we call Series A2, the second alphabetic order. But this Series A2 is never published as book. It's only a database. And in earlier time, we published just microfiches. We have time limits for this project. It is between 1600 and before 1850. This is the focus. And this has also to do with the financement of the series. So these are the limits. For the contributor from outside, it is possible to send also information from sources after 1850. But in Germany and for the Zentralredaktion, we have the focus on this time limit. We publish the series as an online resource only. Then further project printed music, single issues, das ist previous series A1, and collection, also music collections, printed music collections, previous series B1 and 2. They are since 1960, and edition published between it is of editions published between 1500 and 1800. They are cataloged and published as books and CD-ROM, but since July 2015, they are also in our online catalog. Further project series B3 to 15, different subjects like manuscript of polyphonic music, 14th to 16th century music theory, antiphons, hymns, and others. And in this year, we will have a further volume of the series. It's about trio sonatas. It will be a book and a database at the same time. And we are at the moment discussing how we can link the data from the database to the RISM online catalog. Then the series C, Directory of Free Music Research. This is a list of libraries, and we create for every library a so-called RISM Siclum. It is just to mention the library in an abbreviated form. This series is also published in 5 volumes, but now we have a collaboration with the YAML AMA, so-called AMA group, archive and archive group, and we want to revise the series C and make a computer database out of this. This is which is coming now if we start with a new MUSCAT program. So this are a nice picture of the books we have. Just if you see it in the library, they are always blue. So published as books, series A1, series B1 and 2, and series B and C. Well, this is the address of our OPAC. The OPAC is developed together with the Bavarian State Library and in Munich and the Berlin State Library Preußischer Kulturbesitz. So we have a very good link also to the libraries in Germany. We have now 1,055,000 records and 935,000 manuscripts about, and 120,000 record of printed editions from series A1 and B1. Again, the two addresses, you can enter the database via our website or directly via opacrisen.info. Tomorrow we will have a demonstration of the online catalog in the university, not here in this place. Just some words to the RISM Library Siegler. You can find the RISM Library Siegler on our website. That's difficult to see. If you search at the right column on the website, and you can come to this this page. And if you ask for anything, you can get a list of the Siegler. This is Mexican Sieglers. And if you click on the Siegler, you can see in the frame here, you can see the entry, the complete entry we have from this library, including in many cases a Google map. If there's a star on the right side, it means we have records from this library. Also, and if you click on the source, if you have the, then you can go directly to the sources of the library with the star. So, how can you use the data? RISM data are open data, and they are also provided as linked open data. So it's a machine-readable form, so machines can exchange data directly with this. We have different possibilities. We have a SRU server. Our data are in MARC21 or MARC XML format. And we have, for the technicians, NG&D beacon. That's a beacon with numbers of names. And you can then access over the beacon to the holdings. Composer names mainly. This is a thing. We have the input program Muscat, or formerly Callisto, then the database, and the different possibilities to access the database from outside. It is in addition to the OPAC, of course. How can you use RISM data? Include RISM data in your local OPAC. That's possible. You can embed your RISM items in your website. There's an example, but I have no time for this. And then you can receive from the RISM Zentralredaktion camera ready copy for printing a catalog of your holdings. Then it is possible to link all data in your country to the RISM data, so the way back. And RISM data can be used as metadata for digitalization projects. This is made by the, for example, by the Dresden Sächsische Landesbibliothek and many others. How can you contribute? RISM Zentralredaktion provides the Muscat project. It will be provided since November this year. We will give it out November this year. Then we give guidelines and free introduction courses. Then existing MARC data can be transferred, other formats on demand, and link to your local catalog can be included in the RISM catalog. Tomorrow I will show some examples about this. Again, our website. And now let me come to the things we just have from Latin America. It is just a few, I'm sorry, but this conference is to improve this. We have knowledge of libraries and built RISM Siegler. RISM knows of 98 libraries in 15 Latin American countries, 28 libraries in Mexico, 17 in Brazil and 12 in Cuba. Latest new information we have from Costa Rica, always Nicaragua and Puerto Rico. We have no information from these countries, not perhaps someone can help. And we have also some entries from records or from manuscripts or prints in Latin American libraries, 459 records from Brazil, 91 from Chile, that is a Libro Sexto. It gives 91 records, 557 records from Mexico, 21 from Uruguay, 37 records from Venezuela, so in total just 1,165 records. That's the situation. Thank you very much for your attention, and I give now to Christina Turkia.